Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you for coming by. Today we are doing a wash and go. I know it's not exactly a wash and go like the name says, but it is a wash and go. That's the name of the hairstyle. Later on, I'm going to do finger coils because I realized that her hair doesn't coil from the root. Her hair is curly already, like it's type 4C hair, very tight coils, beautiful coils, but it doesn't curl from the root, especially as I go further up ahead. So I'm going to be doing finger coils as we go along. But for me, this video was more like therapy. It was therapy creating it, like just doing the shingling. It's so satisfying. And also when I was editing it, I was like, oh my goodness, this is so therapeutic. I wanted to actually keep the whole 1 hour footage of when I was doing this particular hairstyle, but obviously it's not gonna work. So we are gonna chat, we are gonna talk a lot more things than just this hair. Okay, let me just talk about the hair first. I make sure that the hair is well detangled. Detangled hair is the best for finger coils or for a wash and go hairstyle. I think detangled hair is very good for all kinds of hairstyles. It just makes the hairstyle look much nicer than it would. And also, you're not going to be dealing with a lot of tangles when you want to wash your hair after, let's say, a week or two, and then you want to wash your hair from the wash and go hairstyle. Then you don't have to deal with a lot of tangles because your hair is detangled already. All the shed hairs that you need to take out, you normally take out during detanglings, there is a lot of single strand knots that may form. So it is best to do a hairstyle on well detangled hair, especially when you're doing finger coils or you're doing a wash and go. I am using Nasha Organics Leave-In Conditioner to just condition the hair. You know what a leave-in conditioner does, right? It continues to condition the hair and keeps the normal pH of the hair. So I needed a leave-in conditioner, and it also helps with detangling. I needed this leave-in conditioner so that I can get all those benefits. And because I didn't apply a lot of leave-in conditioner, I'm going to use a bit of grapeseed oil just to help me with the detangling as well, and also to just seal all the moisture inside before we put the gel on top. And even with the grapeseed oil, I don't apply too much. A little goes a long way. And then I'm using Echo Styler gel for setting the curls or the coils. That's basically all the things that I'm doing. And as I said earlier, because the hair doesn't curl from the root, I'm just giving it a little boost by coiling it, like doing a finger coil on a very small section so that it can coil from the root or it can curl from the root. You can see all the things that I'm doing, so I don't think there is much need for explanation here more than what we are going to talk about, and which is okay, so it's the end of the year. I'm doing this video in December, so it's the end of the year for a lot of people, and it is also when our bodies are tired and our minds are tired and we are tired all around. And for some time I was just wondering what is happening, like my body was just breaking down, like literally breaking down. My body has been telling me for a while that I am tired, I need to take a break. And I used to just complain that, hey, I need to take a break, I need to take a holiday and all that kind of stuff. And then I went to Zimbabwe. For those who saw my past video, I went to Zimbabwe for a wedding and everything went well. I was trying my best to be safe. I am fine. But I was not feeling well when it comes to my body. My body was tired, and it's been telling me for a while now that I am tired. Please just give me some rest, I am tired. You know, like with the grind, with what I need to do. I got two businesses to run besides this YouTube channel. So you can imagine, two businesses to run, and then comes the social media, the YouTube channel, and I've got a husband, I've got three kids who happen to be boys. I'm not saying boys are more active than girls, but what I'm just saying is it can get very loud and get very, very busy, like proper busy. Dealing with guys, I need to write a book about that. I know I'm not the first mom to have boys only, but I think I need to write a book about living with guys. But anyway, back to the situation which I was facing, which was basically being very tired and not admitting to yourself that you're tired. And when I'm at home, I also do quite a lot. I do gardening, and because it has to be done. Sometimes it's not even because I love gardening. I love seeing the results of the garden, but it has to be done. And sometimes it has to be done in a particular way. We have a gardener who comes once in 2 weeks, but it has to be done in a particular way. And then because I am that kind of a control freak, I end up doing some of the gardening myself, which is like planting and, you know, that kind of a thing. And then I love making clothes. Like, wow. I don't know. I don't know what I love more than the other, doing hair and making clothes. I know I can't exactly do a business out of making clothes, or at least now, but I love making clothes. And I've got lots of fabric, like lots and lots of fabric. So at any given time, I'm thinking of what to make, and it is therapeutic to me, to my mind, but it's not a lot of resting for my body, because it gets busy as well. It is work at the end of the day. As much as my mind and my soul love sewing, my body doesn't like it. Why? Because I get tired. I could actually be sewing the whole weekend from Saturday to Sunday, up to the evening, but I'll be tired. So I have discovered that some of the things that I call hobbies, I don't get a physical rest from them. I get emotional rest. I get spiritual rest as well. Because when I'm sewing, I'm also listening to devotionals. I'm listening to beautiful, calm music. It just calms my mind. Like sewing calms my mind. Gardening calms my mind as well. But it's not as resting as I would want it to be for the body. So yeah, I was tired, like very, very tired. So when I went to Zimbabwe, I actually became ill. For 3 days, I wasn't feeling well. I was away for about 12 days, so at least I had a chance to, you know, to get better and travel back. And thankfully, it wasn't COVID, so I could travel back to South Africa, which was amazing. And then afterwards, my husband called me to Richards Bay, which is a coastal town in South Africa. He called me to Richards Bay because he's been working there for a while and he needed company. I was like, oh yeah, why not? I work online most of the times. If I'm not doing a person's hair, I'm working online. In any case, I now have a salon. So the ladies in the salon, like my stylists, are the ones who are doing the hair when I'm not around. So I was like, why not? I can do most of the stuff that I need to do online anyway. So I could actually go and work from anywhere. So even as I am doing this voiceover, I'm in Richards Bay. Okay, and then I get to Richards Bay, I was fine for one day, and then I became sick. Like, for almost a whole week, I wasn't feeling well. And I was just like, oh my goodness, what a waste. I was literally living next to the coast, next to the beach, but I couldn't go because I wasn't feeling well. Like, my knees were so weak, my body was so painful. I couldn't keep anything down. I was vomiting almost every day. If I was, say, in my 20s or 30s, you'd think I was pregnant, but definitely I'm not pregnant. Hey, I am well over 40, so I am not pregnant, but I was vomiting. Almost everything that I ate, I vomited it out, which was weird. But yeah, I became sick again until I didn't force myself to do stuff, because I was like, oh my goodness, like, I'm here and I'm sick, and now my husband is still enjoying life with his wife. Now he's nursing a sick wife. Oh my goodness, yeah, it wasn't nice. That wasn't nice at all. So I ended up just giving in and sleeping. Like, I would just sleep, wake up, maybe do a bit of work on the computer, like less than an hour's work on the computer, and then just sleep again, and then, yeah, you know, that kind of thing. And I think the flora in my gut as well was complaining, because being on the move, like traveling, I wasn't exactly eating right, so my tummy was complaining, and everything was just a mess. I gave in. I just said, okay, look here, I need rest. This body needs rest. If I don't wake up tomorrow, everything that I'm trying to accomplish will matter nothing, just because I'm not taking care of this body that actually carries the mind, carries the heart, carries everything that I care about. I'm not taking care of the body. So I just had to press stop and just not do anything and just lay there and rest. And I rested, you guys. Oh my goodness. I rested a number of days, actually. I wasn't doing anything. I was just resting because this body needed resting. My sewing machine is not here. My gardening stuff is not here. My garden is not here, actually. So it meant I could only rest. It's either I take a walk to the beach whilst I'm listening to amazing talks on my earphones, or I'm resting, and which is, has been so good for me. It has been so, so good for me, and I'm so grateful that I can do that. So sometimes you just realize that even when you are grinding, like when you've got your hustle or your job, especially for us entrepreneurs, you don't work 9 to 5. Believe me, you work more than 9 to 5. You work from 6 to 6 sometimes, or 6 to 10, because you are working all the time. Even when you don't seem to be working, your mind is working on ideas, on what you can do better, or how you can improve your business, or how you can get more business, and how you can improve your offering. It's a continuous work mind. Like, your mind mind is in the work mode almost all the time. So to switch that off, to actually say, look here, I'm resting, it takes quite a lot of discipline. And it's important to have that discipline. To say, look here, I need to rest and I'm going to rest, and that rest is going to happen on such a day, and you own up to it and you actually rest, and rest the body that is working, that is making the money, that is taking care of people, that is, you know, running the business. Because, girl, running a business, just one business, is no small thing. And running a business in this time where it is so demanding, you have to be on social media, you have to work on your offering to make sure that it is out there and it's the best there is, because everyone is available and it's no longer just you, but you're competing against the whole world. It's quite something that you need to work on. So when that body tells you that, look, girl, I am tired, please give me some rest, give it some rest. Because at the end of the day, you're gonna have a burnout, and you don't really want a burnout. Why? Because then you become sick, and then you're not enjoying your life, and then it's not worth it. When you can't be healthy physically and spiritually and mentally, you cannot manage your business well. So you actually need it for you to make more money. So if you have been putting off resting or postponing the time that you're supposed to be resting just because you need to put in more hours and to make more money and all that kind of stuff, well, then you are just shooting yourself in the foot, so to say, because you will not be able to give your all to that particular job or to the project or to your business, because you haven't given yourself some rest so that you can have more energy, you can apply your mind, you can give it your all. And if you don't have anything to give it from, so if you've just been giving and giving and giving towards this business or towards your job or towards your project, if you're giving and giving and there is nothing left, then there won't be anything to give. In the end, that's when businesses fail, that's when people get a burnout, so, and they start hating their jobs just because they haven't given themselves time to rest. So it is important just to switch off and say, look here, I'm resting. If you've got kids, I know that is a little bit difficult, because when I'm at home, resting is almost impossible unless I send the kids away. So my kids are a little bit grown, and somehow we space them quite a lot. So I've got 3 kids, yes, but they're not all under 5. When I want to rest, I normally send my kids to my friends, because I don't have family in South Africa. I don't have family to take over my kids, but I've got a community of friends, of the ladies that I go to church with, and I've got that support to say, I've got friends whom I can just call and say, please, can you come and fetch my kids, because I'm not at home. And the one that I really need to make arrangements for is the last one, because he's only 9. So that's the one that I normally make arrangements for. The other guys, the older boys, they can make their own arrangements. They just tell me about them, and if it's okay, it's okay. So I do get these moments of getting rest. But if you don't have friends, like a community of friends, of people that you can rely on to take over your kids when you need some rest, well, get a babysitter so that you can recharge your energy. Well, raising kids is a lot of work. So if you don't take rest, you're going to keep on giving off your energy, giving off your love, giving off yourself to your kids, to your job, to your project, to your business. And when you give from nothing, you end up running dry, running out. And when you run out, that's when you have a burnout. And when you have a burnout, you can't take care of your kids, you can't take care of your business, you can't take care of your job, you can't take care of the project that you've been working on. In the end, everything becomes a mess. So guys, it is important to take some rest. It's for the good of your business, it's for the good of your job, your project, it's for the good of your family as well. Your children actually need a present mother. I know of some mothers who have started resenting their kids. Some start taking drugs just to cope with this thing called motherhood. Let's admit it, it's not easy, and sometimes you need time off. And that time off, you've got to be mindful on your own that I need to take some rest, and this is the rest that I'm going to take. I'm going to take it on these days. And everyone else just needs to get used to it, that you're going to take some rest. You're not asking for permission, you are just taking some time off, because we need rest, you need rest, everyone needs some form of rest, just to shut everything out and concentrate on healing, on recharging, on rejuvenating all that goodness that you're always giving on each and every day. I know it's a mouthful, but you guys, I just had to say it, and here it is. So yeah, we're done with that now. And if you're not subscribed, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification button so that you don't miss any of the videos that I post on this channel. Thank you so, so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. God bless you. Bye.